G'day and welcome to the Tech Math Channel. This video we're going to be having a look at a way that you can use your hands in order to work out some of the times tables specifically involving, and these numbers only, 6s, 7s, 8s, 9s and 10s. Okay, so it's a good little method for just especially for guys first working out their times tables who tend to be struggling a bit. I got my kids doing a few of these mainly because they are struggling with a few of the ones like 7/8 and things like this. And these are just a little trick just for those guys who need that extra little bit of help. Okay, or for anybody who's just sort of interested in cool maths tricks, which is me. Okay, so this is the way this works. We've got our left hand here and we've got our right hand here. Okay, and we've got our thumbs pointing inwards here, okay, as you can see. I haven't used my own hands are far too hideous for this, but what we do is we number from our thumbs outwards, our fingers, so we start with a 6, a 7, an 8, a 9, it's a 9, and a 10, okay, so this one also is a 6, a 7, an 8, a 9, and a 10. Okay, and the way this works is this. What you do is, say we have a question such as, look, let's think of one here. We'll go a nice easy one, 6 times 8. Okay, 6 times 8. The way this works is this. Say you get this number, we have our 6 here and our 8 here. You would touch these two fingers together. Okay, so if we were to do this, okay, we would actually have these two fingers touching one another, and you could probably imagine that. And when we do that, we're going to end up with all these fingers in a group together, okay? So we end up with our 6 and our 8. We end up with all these fingers on one side and all our fingers on the outside of this. That's these fingers here, okay? And the way we get our answer is this. The first part of our answer, we just add all these fingers on the inside part, the fingers closest to us together, including the ones that are touching. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. Okay. With the other fingers, what we have is we have 4 over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we have 2 over here. 1, 2. And we times these two numbers together. 4 times 2 is 8. That's our answer. 48. Wait a second. Surely that doesn't work for all of them, I hear you say. So we'll have a bit of a look at a few more of these, okay? Alright, so the question I'm going to do now is a different one. Say 9 times 8. Okay, now how do we work out this? Well, what we would do is we would stick the 9 finger and the 8 finger together. I want you to give this a go. Hopefully you've written the numbers on your hands and you do this right now. But you'll stick this 9 finger here. I'll colour that in red because red tends to show up a lot nicer. So this 9 finger here and this 8 finger here. So we group all of these fingers together. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 fingers that are going to be pointing closest to you, including the pointers. 7. Over here we have 1. Over here we have 2. And we multiply these. 1 times 2 is 2. Pretty cool, right? Okay, I'll give one last example of this. I'll get rid of these. So, what about another one? In fact, I said one before that one of my son tended to struggle with a whole lot, which was this one. 7 times 8. Okay, so we get 7 times 8. Here's the 7. Here's the 8. Put those two fingers together, the ones that are closest towards you, including that particular one, are going to encompass all of these fingers. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Over here we have 3 fingers on the outer. Over here we have 2 fingers on the outer. 3 times 2 is 6. The answer is 56. It's a pretty cool trick, right? Anyway, I hopefully you've got the swing of those. It's a really, really great little trick, especially for guys who are struggling a little bit with their times tables. So I hope you found that really handy. Remember, you permanently have to keep those numbers written on your fingers. In fact, I recommend get a tattoo. Get them tattooed on your fingers, then you'll never need to carry a calculator ever again. Okay. Hopefully, that's some help. See ya.